Bhajana Shalakaya Chaksur Militanena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishtaya Bhutale Shrimati Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Saraswati Devi Gauravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Desatarine Vanchakaupata Rubyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Pavane Bhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadhi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. All right, so we're going through the Srimad Bhagavatam, 6th canto, and we're hearing about how the demigods are having a lot of trouble from a big demon named Vritasura. Hari Bol, Subhuti Prabhu.
Hare Krishna, Kurte.
Hare Krishna, I'm coming, sorry.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, so I have to say it
sorry,
again.
Sorry,
okay, so we're hearing about, we're in the sixth canto, and we're hearing about the history of the demon Vritasura.
我们现在学习的是圣典博伽瓦坛第六篇，了解的是维特苏拉这个恶魔的历史。
Vritasura was a demon who was created by Twasta. Twasta was actually a brahmana, and he created the demon because his son was murdered by Indra. So he created a demon to kill Indra.
Vritasura is a demon. It is from Twasta he created, because Twasta's son was murdered by Indra.
So he created the demon. Twasta created the demon Vritasura to kill Indra.
所以托斯塔创造了这个维特苏拉，原本是想去杀印度的。But
he got the mantra wrong, and so there were some problems.
但是他在念诵 曼陀罗的时候出现了错误，所以出现了一些问题。Mantras
are very special, and if each letter has to be pronounced exactly perfect. And if it's supposed to be long sound and you make it a short sound, then the whole mantra can change.
Mantolo is very special. Every note should be perfectly pronounced. If it was originally a long note, when you pronounce it, it becomes a short note. The whole meaning will be changed.
So, anyway, when Vritasura appeared, the demigods were completely overwhelmed. They didn't know what to do. They could not begin to do battle with him.
When Vritasura, this evil demon, was created, all these half-demons were shocked. They didn't know how to deal with this evil demon. They couldn't fight against him.
They threw their weapons at Vritasura. Vritasura just swallowed them.
These half-demons went to the evil demon.
So the demigods decided they had to go to Lord Narayan and ask him for help.
So the 半神 就决定准备去找主拿尔央的，向他祈求帮助。
So we're hearing the prayers which they offered to Lord Narayan.
我们现在听到的是他们向半，就是半神人向主拿尔央的供奉的祷文。
So they're described about Lord Narayan, that he's beyond the material existence.
他们在描述主拿尔扬呢，是完全超越物质存在。
And nothing surprises him.
他永远不会为任何的事情感到惊讶。
He's always very happy and fully satisfied.
他永远的喜乐，永远的自我满足。
He has no material designations.
他没有任何物质的头衔。
So he's very steady and detached.
因此他非常的稳定，而且不依附。
And he's a real shelter for everyone.
他是每一个人的真正庇护所。
And if anybody takes shelter of anybody other than the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Lord Narayan, then he must be a fool.
如果一个人想要去托庇除了拉尔央纳之外的另外一个人的话，他一定是一个傻瓜。
They say just if you take the shelter of somebody else who's not the Supreme Personality of Godhead, then it's like trying to cross the ocean by holding the tail of a dog.
就有一个比喻，比如说，就是说，如果我们不托庇于主拿尔扬纳的话，托庇于其他人的话，就好像我们在托庇于一个想要穿越于海洋的一条狗。
Now dogs, they do swim, you know. I used to see it every morning when I would walk in Hong Kong. I would see this one man. He would swim in the sea there at Hong Kong, and he could swim with his dog.
当我在香港早上去散步的时候，我经常看到有一个男的去遛狗的时候，他的这个小狗就在这个游泳池里面游泳。
So dogs can swim, but if you think you can hold the tail of a dog and it can pull you across the ocean, then you have to be really crazy.
这个小狗是确实可以游泳的，但是如果你想认为你想依靠这个小狗抓着它的尾巴去穿越海洋的话，这是一个很疯狂的想法。
So the same way, if you think you can cross the ocean of material existence by taking the shelter of anybody other than the Supreme Lord, if you take the shelter of a demigod, then that's also foolish.
同样的道理，如果我们想托庇于其他的半神人或其他的别人的话，想托庇于他们来穿越物质存在的这个海洋的话，这也是一个很疯狂的想法。
Yeah, we have to understand that only the lotus feet of the Supreme Personality of Godhead can deliver us from material existence.
我们需要理解的是，只有至尊人格首身的莲花足才能够把我们渡过这个物质存在的海洋。
One time, Prabhupada was in the hospital, and the doctor came with this huge needle, a very big needle, and he stuck the needle into Prabhupada.
有一次，圣帕帕德住在医院，然后这个医生带了一个非常大的这个针，想要去扎圣帕帕德。
So after he put the needle into Prabhupada, then the doctor went away. And so the devotee asked Prabhupada, Srila Prabhupada, was it very painful?
当这个医生给圣帕帕德扎完之后，他离开了。然后周边的奉献者就问圣帕帕德，您痛吗？
And Prabhupada quoted this verse from the Srimad Bhagavatam.This verse is from the 10th canto Srimad Bhagavatam. This very famous verse. It says, Samashritaye padapalavam plavam mahatpadam punyayasho marare bhavam buddhir vatsapadam parampadam padam padam yadvipadam natesham. So the meaning is thatThe lotus feet of Krishna are like a boat.
圣帕帕德当时就引述了《圣典波迦瓦坛》第十篇的这一个诗节，刚刚古玛哈拉杰背诵了这个梵文，这个意思是主的莲花足是一艘不可毁灭的船。
So if we take shelter of that boat, of the lotus feet of Krishna, then we can cross the ocean of material existence.
如果我们能够脱避于那条船的话，便可以轻而易举地跨越物质存在的无知之洋。
Even though a devotee lives in the material world, there's no danger for a devotee.
虽然奉献者即便奉献者居住在这个物质世界，对于他来说也仍然没有危险。
But the material world is full of dangers everywhere.
但是物质世界每一步每一个地方却充满着危险。
But these dangers cannot touch the devotee.
但是这样的危险不能触碰奉献者。
Because the devotee is taking shelter.Of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, so he's protected by the grace of Krishna.
因为奉献者完全脱避于至尊主的莲花足，所以至尊主保护着这样的奉献者。
But if we depend on our own mind and our own ideas, then we will never get protection.
然而，如果我们只是脱避于依靠于我们自己的心意和我们自己的想法，我们不会得到这样的保护。
So the demigods tell Lord Narayan, they say to Lord Narayan, they tell him about the Manu. There was one Manu named King Satyavrat.
现在这是半神人在描述有一个马鲁，有一个祖先叫 Satyavrat。
Vrat, yeah. So Satyavrat, he happened to be around at the time when the world was all annihilated. There was a destruction. The whole world was flooded. So he saved himself by. He got in a small boat, and the boat he attached the boat to the horn.Of the Matsya Avatar, the fish incarnation.
这个 Satyavrat 王曾经在地球，就是在这个宇宙的毁灭的时候，发了大洪水的时候，他把自己的这条小船和 Matsya 这个至尊主的鱼的这个化身给绑了起来，拴了起来，然后得到了拯救。
Yeah, by the Matsya Avatar.He saved Manu from the flood.
这个 Matsya, 至尊主鱼的这个 Matsya 化身，拯救了 Satyavrata 王，把他从洪水之中拯救了出来。
So the demigods pray to Lord Narayan. They say, "May that same fish incarnation save us from the great danger of this demon, who is the son of Twasta."
这个半神人们也同样的祈祷道，希望那一位同样的那一位化身 Matsya 的那位化身也同样的能够拯救我们于危险之中，拯救我们，把我们从 Twasta 的儿子的这种危险之中拯救出来。
But then the demigods continued. They said that at the beginning of the creation, there was a tremendous wind, very big, strong wind.And it caused a lot of waves, big waves in the sea.
半神人继续说道，在创造之初，有一场巨大的飓风引发了很多的波涛汹涌的洪水。
So that when all the big waves were there on the sea, it made a horrible sound.
当这个水的波浪在拍打的时候，引发了巨大的恐怖的声响。
And Lord Brahma, he was sitting on his lotus flower, and when he heard the sound, he almost fell from his seat. He almost fell into the water.
主 Brahma 坐在他的莲花座上，他听到了这个声响之后，他几乎也要从他的座上跌落下来，掉到水之中。
But the Lord saved him. With the help of the Lord, he was saved.
但是在主的帮助之下，他得到了拯救。
So the demigods pray that We also hope the Lord will protect us from our dangerous condition.
半世人就祈祷着，祈祷道：我们也希望主在这样危难的情况下保护我们。
And then the demigods tell about the personality of Godhead, how he created from his external energy. He created the material world.
半世人接着说道，至尊主通过他的外在能力创造了我们，创造了这个物质世界。
And by his mercy,We can expand the creation of the universe.
通过他的仁慈，我们又扩展了这个宇宙的创造。
And we know that the personality of Godhead is always with us as a super soul, but we can't see him.
我们知道至尊主、至尊人格守神，他总是以超灵的形式和我们在一起，但是我们无法看见他。
And the demigods say we are not able to see the supersoul because all of us think that we are separate and independent, and we think we are God. We're thinking we are ourselves the supreme God.
半世人说，我们之所以无法看见。这个超灵形式存在的至尊人格守神本人，是因为我们认为我们自己是分离的，而且独立的神本人。
So this is how the conditioned souls, this is why we cannot see the Supreme Lord face to face.
这就是我们为什么无法面对面的见到至尊主本人。
Even though Krishna comes before us as Lord Krishna or Lord Rama, but And Krishna lives in our human society, but still we're not able to understand him.
即便主 Krishna, 即便至尊主作为主 Krishna 或主 Rama 的形式出现在我们面前，但是我们无法明白他。
We're thinking when the Lord comes as Lord Krishna or Lord Rama, we're thinking he's an ordinary person.
我们认为这个来的主 Krishna 主 Rama 他是一个普通人而已。
And we think that we're just like him, we're on his level.
而且我们还认为我们跟他是在同一个层面上的。
We think we can also create a universe.
我们认为我们自己也可以创造一个宇宙。
Or we think we can create another God.
我们还认为我们可以创造另外一个神。
So this is why we cannot understand the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
这就是为什么我们无法理解至尊人格守神本人。
So we are all conditioned to different degrees, but we all think that we are God.
我们都是受条件限制的，不同程度上我们都是受条件限制的。而且我们都认为我们自己就是神。
That's why we cannot understand Krishna, and that's why we cannot see him face to face.
这就是为什么我们无法面对面的理解 Krishna 或面对面的见到他。
So the demigods continue to offer prayers, and they talk about the inconceivable potency of the Supreme Lord.
半世人继续向至尊主供奉祷文，他描述了至尊主不可思议的能力能量。
And by this inconceivable potency, he can take many different transcendental forms.
通过他不可思议的能量，他可以创造不同形式的形体，不同种类的形体。
Like the form of Lord Vamanadeva. Lord Vamanadeva.
就像主。
The incarnation of strength among the demigods.
就像主 Vamanadev, 他一种力量的化身，半世人之中力量的化身。
Or Parasuram, the incarnation among saints.
或者 Parasurama, 圣者之中的化身 ，Parasurama.
And Nrsingadeva and Varaha incarnations among animals.
动物之中的化身主 Nrsingadeva 和主 Varaha.
And Matsya and Kurma incarnations among the aquatics.
水生动物之中的化身主 Matsya 和主 Kurma.
So in this way, the Supreme Lord accepts many different transcendental bodies.
就这样，主接受了各种不同的超人形体。
Sometimes among the human beings, and sometimes among other species of life.
有些时候是在人类的形体之中，有些时候是在其他种类的形体之中。
And of course, special forms are when he comes as Lord Rama and Lord Krishna.
当然，他很特别的形体是主 Rama 和主 Krishna。
And the Lord always gives mercy to the demigods. He always wants to protect the demigods because they get a lot of trouble from the demons.
主总是给予了特别多的仁慈给予半神人，他保护着半神人，因为半神人总是被这些恶魔所打扰。
So the Supreme Lord is the supreme worshipable deity for all living entities.
所以至尊主是值得崇拜的神体，他是每一个所有的生物值得崇拜的神。
And he is the supreme cause, both the male and female creative energies.
他是至高无上的原因，以男性和女性创造力为代表。
So although he's different from this universe.He comes into the in this universe. He exists in his universal form, which is the form of the universe. But at the same time, he's different from the universe.
一方面他又不同于这个宇宙，另外一个方面他又以宇宙形体的形式存在和来显现。
So the demigods say that we're very afraid, so we're taking shelter of him because we know that he can give us protection.
So the 半神人说我们非常的害怕，但是我们也非常想托庇于他，我们知道他能给予我们保护。
So we can see how the demigods appreciate Lord Vishnu as the original cause of the creation of the material world.
所以我们看到半神人他们是多么欣赏至尊主威士努，他作为整个物质创造的原因，至尊的原因。
So some people they think Prakriti is the cause of the material creation. They think everything just evolved from matter.
有一些人认为Prakriti 是创造的原因，说一切都是来自于物质。
But we see in the prayers of the demigods, they're saying.Everything is the cause of the Supreme Lord.
但是我们从半神的祷文可以看到，一切都是由于至尊主而产生的。
So although the material world comes from Prakriti, the Prakriti is the energy of the Supreme Lord.
虽然物质宇宙是来自于主的 Prakriti 这个能量，但是 Prakriti 也是来自于至尊主本人。
And the living entities, they're the Purusha, they're also the energy of the Lord.
个体生物 Purusha, 它也是就是 Purusha 也是至尊主的能量。
Yeah, the living entities are the superior energy to the Prakriti.Prakriti is the inferior energy, and the living entities are the superior energy.
物质自然是较低等的能量，而个体生物是较高等的能量。
So both the Prakriti and the Purush, they enter the Supreme Lord.
不管是 Prakriti 还是 Purusha, 他们都进入到至尊主之中。
And that is mentioned in the Bhagavad Gita.
这个在《薄伽梵歌》之中有描述。
at the time of the annihilation, the Prakriti and the Purusha, they will enter back into the body of the Supreme Lord.
在一切创造的结尾，一切都进入到至尊主的身体之中。
So it appears like the Prakriti and the Purusha are the cause of the whole material world.
好像显现为 Prakriti 是这个物质自然的原因。
But actually both the Prakriti and the Purusha are different energies of the Supreme Lord.
但事实上 Prakriti 也好 Purusha 也好都是至尊主的能量的流影而已。
He is the original cause. The Supreme Lord is the original cause of everything.
至尊主是一切的根源。
So in the Bhagavad Gita, it's also mentioned how Krishna enters the Prakriti.
在《薄伽梵歌》中描述了主 Krishna 是如何进入到 Prakriti 之中。
And then the Prakriti creates different manifestations.
然后 Prakriti 创造出不同的这个展示出不同的东西出来。
Yeah, Prakriti is not independent.
Prakriti 不是独立的。
It's beyond the energies of the Supreme Lord. The Prakriti is not independent and it's not beyond his energies. It is one of his energies.
Prakriti 不是独立的，也不是在主的能量之上，它是在主的能量之中。
And Krishna is the original cause of everything.
Krishna 是一切的根源。
So that's described in the Bhagavad Gita also in the 10th chapter.
这些都在《薄伽梵歌》中的第十章之中有描述。
Krishna says, "Aham sarvasya prabhavo mata sarvam pravartate iti madva bhajante mam buddha bhava samanvita." Krishna says, "I am the source of all the material and spiritual worlds."
主 Krishna 说，我是所有物质世界和灵性世界的根源。
Krishna said, everything emanates from me.
一切都流源自我。
And the wise who know this engage in my devotional service and worship me with all their hearts.
了解到这一点的智者为我做奉献服务，全心全意地崇拜我。
And it's also stated like this in the second canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam, in the original Chaturshloki, the four verses, which are the original verses of the Srimad Bhagavatam.
这一点在圣典薄伽瓦坛的第二篇的四个 Chaturshloki 之种子诗节中也有描述。
Right, these four verses come in the 9th chapter of the second canto, beginning text number 33.
圣典波这个来起始于圣典薄伽瓦坛第二篇第九章三十三诗节。
Krishna says, "Aham eva sham eva gre nanyat yat samat." Krishna said, "I existed before the creation."
Krishna 说，只有我在创造之前存在着。
So to generate the universe, the Supreme Lord acts.Indirectly is the Purusha.
为了产生宇宙，主间接的以 Purusha.
And he acts.
就是说，
He acts indirectly as the Purusha. Purusha means the living entities. So indirectly, that's Krishna.
为了产生宇宙，主间接的是以 Purusha. Purusha 指的是这个个体生物。
And Krishna acts directly as the Prakriti, material nature, his material nature.
主间接的以 Purusha, 直接的是以 Prakriti 行动。
So, because both energies come from Lord Vasudev, who is the personality of Godhead,
因为这两种能量都是从主至尊人格守神 Vasudeva 那里来的。
So Krishna, the Vasudeva is known as both the Prakriti and the Purush. Therefore, Vasudeva is the cause of everything.
主 Vasudeva 他既是 Prakriti 也是 Purusha， 他以二者著称，所以 Vasudeva 是万事万物的原因。
So while the demigods were offering prayers to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Lord Narayan, then at that time the Lord appeared to them.
当半神人向至尊主拿儿央的供奉这个祷文的时候，那个时候，至尊主显现。
Right. The Supreme Lord appeared first of all in their hearts, and then he appeared in front of them.
至尊主首先显现在他们的心中，然后接着出现在他们的面前。
And they could see he was the Supreme Lord. He was carrying his weapons. He was carrying the conch shell, and the disc, and the club.
至尊主显现的时候是带着他的武器，海螺、神碟，还有神锤。
And he didn't come alone. He was surrounded and served by 16 personal attendants.
他不是一个人来的，他随从有16位私人的侍从跟着他一起来。
And these 16 servants, they were also decorated with ornaments, and they appeared just like him.They had also four armed forms.
这十六个仆人，他们也佩戴着饰物，看上去和主一模一样。
But the only difference was they didn't have the mark of Srivatsa on their chest.
他们和主唯一的不同是，只是他们没有 Srivatsa 这个标志。
And they didn't have the Kastuba jewel around the neck.
而且他们的脖子上也没有带这个 Kastuba 宝石。
So when all the demigods saw the Supreme Lord, and they saw him smiling with eyes like lotus petals, so they became very happy.
当半神人见到至尊主的时候，看到至尊主那种很微笑，而且那种姿势微笑着，而还有他。美丽莲花般的眼睛，他们都非常，半神人都非常的快乐。
They immediately fell down on the ground, offering dandavats.
这半神人立即就拜倒在地，五体投地的顶拜。
This is what we should do when, if the Supreme Lord comes in front of us, we have to offer full obeisances.
这就是我们应该做的。当至尊主显现在我们面前的时候，我们就应该这么去做，就五体投地的顶拜。
So they slowly got up, and then they pleased the Lord. They continued to offer him prayers.
所以他们慢慢起身，向至尊主供奉祷文。
So we should understand the special features of the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
我们要理解至尊主特别的标志。
Right, the main difference being this Srivatsa mark and the Kastuba gem. That's only on the Supreme Lord, not on all the other inhabitants of Vaikuntha.
就是 Srivatsa 这个标志，还有 Kastuba 宝石，这个只是在至尊主的身上才有，外昆塔的其他的人身上是没有这两个。这两样很特别的。
Yeah, when you go to Vaikuntha, you'll see everybody looks just like the Supreme Lord. You won't know who's the Supreme Lord. You have to look to see the Srivatsa mark and the Kastuba gem. Then you'll know who is actually the Supreme Lord. But everybody looks the same.
当你去到 Vaikuntha 的时候，你看见每一个人都好像跟至尊主一样。但呢，只有至尊主本人，他有这个 Kastuba 宝石和 Srivatsa 这个标志。当你看到这两样特别的标志的时候，你就确认这是至尊主本人。
So the demigods address the Supreme Lord, and they tell him that you are competent, you can give us the results of sacrifice.
班神人开始又来描述至尊主，荣耀至尊主，他说，你能够给予我们祭祀的结果。
And you are the time factor, destroys all the results in due course.
您也是时间因素，摧毁所有的这些结果。
And you have the chakra, the Sudarshan chakra, to kill the demons.
您还有 Sudarshan chakra, 神蝶，可以杀所有的恶魔。
So the demigods pray that we, O Lord, you have many names, we offer our obeisances unto you.
半神人说，哦，我的主啊，你有太多的名字，我向您致以卑微的顶拜。
Then they continued to pray. They said, O Supreme Controller, you control the three destinations.
班神人继续供奉祷文，说，至尊控制者，您控制着三个目的地。
Right, the three destinations. One is to go up to the heavenly planets.
有三个目的地，一个是上面的天堂星球。
One is to come back as a human being.
第二个是人类。
And the other is to be condemned and have to go into hell.
第三个是在地狱中受审的那些。
But the demigods also know that the Lord has his supreme abode, which is Vaikuntha, in the spiritual world.
半神人也知道，至尊主有他自己的星球，在是外昆塔。
So the demigods say, we appeared after you created this cosmic world.
半神人说，我们是在您创造了这个宇宙展示之后才显现的。
And your activities, we cannot understand your activities. It's impossible for us to understand.
要我们来理解您的活动，简直是不可能的。
So Prabhupada explains that a person who has no real experience, he does not know what to ask from the Supreme Lord.
圣帕帕德在这里解释道，一个人通常没有经验的情况下，他不知道该向至尊主请求什么。
Because everyone is under the control of the material world.
因为每一个人都是在物质自然的控制之下。
So nobody knows what they should ask for when they pray to the Supreme Lord.
所以没有人知道该向至尊主去祈祷什么。
But a lot of people pray, they want to go to the heavenly planets.
但是很多人他们都祈祷着说，希望自己能够去到天。
They don't have any information about Vaikuntha.
他们对外昆塔星球一无所知。
But there are different planets, different places to go. Just like there's Devaloka, where all the demigods reside.
但是确实有不同的地方是可以去的，比如说 Devaloka 就是半神人所居住的星球。
And then there's Pitriloka, where all the forefathers live.
还有 Pitriloka 就是祖先们，四个祖先们他们居住的星球。
And then there's Niraya, which is where all the hellish planets are.
还有 Niraya, 那些是地狱星球。
But we can transcend all these systems. These are all in the material world. We can go beyond that and go to the spiritual world.
这些都是属于物质世界的这些星球，但是我还可以超越这个物质世界。
If we go to Vaikuntha Loka, then we get the shelter of the Vaishnavas.
如果我们能够去到 Vaikuntha 的话，我们就能得到 Vaishnava 们的庇护。
Vaishnavas, they don't care about these other planets in the material world.
Vaishnava 的终极圣地，他们和这些物质世界，他们是没有关系的。
So the demigods are praying. They say, O Supreme Lord, O Narayan, O Vasudev, original person.
半神人祈祷道，哦，至尊人格首神啊，Narayana， Vasudeva 原始的人啊。
And they say, oh, most exalted person, supreme experience.
最崇高的人啊，至高无上的经验。
Welfare personified.
最具福利的化身。
Oh, supreme benediction, supremely merciful and changeless.
至尊的祝福，至尊的仁慈，永无变化的人啊。
Oh, support of the cosmic manifestation.
宇宙展示的支撑者。
Master of everything and husband of the goddess of fortune.
一切的拥有者，幸运女神的丈夫啊。
You are realized by the best sannyasis who wander about the world to preach Krishna consciousness.
您被最好的、最高觉悟的 sannyasi 他们所觉悟，您他们在这个世界传播着 Krishna 知觉，漫游传播着 Krishna 知觉。
They're fully absorbed in samadhi through bhakti yoga.
他们通过奉爱瑜伽完全沉醉于萨玛迪之中。
And because their minds are concentrated upon you, they can understand, they know about your personality.
因为他们的心意完全专注于您，所以他们能够了解您的人格。
Because they purified their hearts by the bhakti yoga.
因为他们通过奉爱瑜伽净化了他们的内心。
And when we get rid of all the darkness from the heart, then you are revealed to them fully.
当他们的内心完全的，他们内心的黑暗完全被清除的时候，您会揭示您自己给他们。
And they enjoy the transcendental form of your lordship.
他们会享受您他们会享受您超然的形体。
So only these people can actually realize you.
只有这样的人才能够觉悟你。
So we just offer our humble obeisances unto you.
我们只是向您致以虔敬的顶拜。
So we should understand how the Supreme Lord has many different names describing his different qualities.
我们要了解的是至尊主有很多不同的名字，有他不同的品质，他有许许多多的名字。
Because Krishna appears differently to different devotees and to different types of transcendentalists.
因为至尊主他向不同的奉献者揭示他不同的超然的形体。
Just like the Gyanis, they will realize the impersonal feature of the Lord and they will know him as the Supreme Brahman.
就像那些 Gyani 思辨者，他们觉悟非人格的形体的时候，他则称之为至尊的 Brahman。
And the yogis meditating on the super soul, they will realize the Lord as Paramatma, so they will call him Antaryami, which means one who resides inside.
当这些人他们在觉悟超灵的时候。他们称至尊主为安塔亚米，安塔亚米就是那位居住在内在的那一位。
And the Lord also expands himself in different forms for the creation of the material world. At that time, he is called Shirodakasai Vishnu, Garbhodakasai Vishnu, and Karanodakasai Vishnu.
当至尊主为了扩展他的各种形体，以利于物质的创造时，他被称为 Shirodakshayi Vishnu、Garbhodakshayi Vishnu 和 Karanodakshayi Vishnu。
Karanodakshayi Vishnu is Mahavishnu。
Karanodakshayi Vishnu 是指 Mahavishnu。
So he's laying in the Karana Ocean, the causal ocean.
他住在蕴诞之洋之中。
And Garbhodakasai Vishnu, he's in the universe. He's at the bottom of the universe.
And Garbhodakasai Vishnu, 他是在宇宙，他在 宇宙的底部。
And Shirodakshayi Vishnu, he's laying in the milk ocean. He has got his island, Swetadweep, where he lives.
而 Shirodakshayi Vishnu, 他在牛奶之洋，他的那个岛叫 Swetadweep。
And he is also the super soul in the hearts of all living entities.
而且 Shirodakshayi Vishnu 也是指的那位超灵，在每一个众生心中的那位超灵。
So these are all different expansions of Lord Vishnu for the creation of the material world.
这是至尊主的为了创造的时候的不同的形体。
But then there are forms above the form of Vishnu, higher than the form of Vishnu.
在 Vishnu 的觉悟之上，还有觉悟。
There is the Chaturvyuha, which means the forms of Vasudeva, Sankarshan, Prajumna, and Aniruddha.
还有这个被称为 Chaturvyuha。指的是 Vasudeva, Shankarshan, Prajumna, and Aniruddha.
So they are all different forms of Lord Vishnu, but they are higher than the three forms of Vishnu for material creation.
这就是不同的主 Vishnu 以及在 Vishnu 之上的这些形体。
Yeah, these Chaturvyuha, they live in the spiritual world.
这个 Chaturvyuha 是在灵性，他们居住在灵性世界。
And then there's another form which is called the Vaikuntha Narayan.
然后再之后是的形体称为Vaikuntha的 Narayana.
So that's in the Vaikuntha planets. But then above the Vaikuntha planets, you have Lord Baladev.
在外昆塔的星球之上还有主巴拉德瓦。
And then above Baladeva, then we have Krishna.
在巴拉德瓦之上是对主 Krishna 的觉悟。
So whenever you engage in devotional service, we can realize Krishna in all of these different forms.
当一个人完全从事于奉献服务的时候，他能够觉悟到至尊主的所有的这些顶体。
We have to remove the covering from our heart so that we can realize these things.
我们要去除掉内心的这些覆盖，然后至尊主可以揭示给我们。
So this is what the process of devotional service is about. It requires that we remove the covering from our eyes so we can properly see the Supreme Lord.
这也是奉爱瑜伽的这个程序，我们能去除掉内心的这些覆盖，然后能够慢慢的见到至尊主。
And we see how Krishna can appear in so many different forms to so many different people.
我们可以看到至尊主以各种各样不同的形体展现给各种各样不同的人。
Because we know we have a lot of materialistic people, so they don't see Krishna at all, they just see the material world.
我们也知道还有很多这些物质主义的人，他们只看到这些物质的形体，他们无法看见至尊主。
But then you've got some people who are a little pious and they follow scripture, but for material purposes.
之后我们还了解到有一些人他们比较的虔诚，虽然他们也是物质，但是他们有一些虔诚的心，他们能够通过经典去看。
And then above that, then you've got transcendentalists, and then you've got the people who focus on the impersonal aspect of the Lord, like the Gyanis or the Vedantists.
而在这个虔诚的之上，我们又了解到还有一些迪亚尼思辨者，他们可能是非人格主义者，或者说思辨者，他们有他们的这个觉悟。
And then you've got also the yogis meditating on the super soul.
还有一些，在这之后就是有一些 yogi 瑜伽师，他们在觉悟着超灵、至尊主超灵的部分。
And then you've got the devotees who meditate on the Supreme Lord, Bhagavan.
在这之后我们就了解到有奉献者他们在觉悟着至尊主八个半的至尊凡的层面。
Now we see there's a lot of devotees of Lord Vishnu and they think Lord Vishnu is the original supreme and that Lord Krishna he's the expansion from Vishnu。
在奉献者之中我们还了解到有些人他是主 Vishnu 的奉献者，他们认为主 Krishna 是主 Vishnu 的化身。
And they think Vaikuntha is the supreme destination. They just want to go to Vaikuntha. They think Vaikuntha is the supreme abode.
他们认为，Vaikuntha 是至高无上的目的地，是最终的目的地。他们认为主 Vishnu 是至尊。
And there are many Vaishnavas who worship Lord Vishnu as the supreme Lord.
还有一些 Vaishnava 他们把至尊把主 Vishnu 作为至尊的主。
And then you got some people they're devoted to Lord Ramachandra and so Lord Ramachandra he has his place。
我们还有一些奉献者他们崇拜着主 Ramachandra 然后主 Ramachandra 也有他的地方。
And you've got also people who worship the Lord in Dwarka. Lord is Dwarkadish.And they worship Krishna in that mood. Krishna has his wives and he lives there in Dwarka and they worship him as the Supreme Lord.
We have some devotees, they worship Dwarka's Lord Krishna. They worship Dwarka Dish, which is Lord Krishna and his wife.
And then we've got other people who know about Vrindavan and they worship Krishna in Vrindavan where Krishna...is performing his pastimes with all the people of Vrindavan.
我们还有一些奉献者，他们崇我们的奉献者是崇拜着 Vrindavan 的 Krishna， 他扮演着木牛童的这个形象。
It's also mentioned, you know, some people are devotees of Lord Shiva. So where do they go? So Lord Shiva, he is a planet which is between the material and the spiritual world.
有一些人就问，有那么崇拜主西巴的人，他应该去哪里呢？主西巴其实也有他的星球，他在物质世界和灵性世界之间的那个地方，有他的自己的居所。
Yeah, between the Lord Shiva's place is called Kailash, and the devotees of Lord Shiva who don't know about the who don't understand about Vaikuntha and about the Supreme Lord, they worship Lord Shiva as the supreme. They go there.
主西瓦的奉献者就是那些不理解有外昆塔也不理解有至尊主 Krishna 的这个主西瓦的奉献者，他们会去到凯拉什，就是说去到主西瓦的 地方，就主西瓦所在的地方被称为凯拉什。
And even the Buddhists they also go there to this place between the material and spiritual world.
这个佛教的就是佛主佛陀的他的追随者，他们也去到的是灵性世界和物质世界的这一块地方。
Because they don't believe in the spiritual world, they only know about matter, and they think the soul is also matter. They think the soul can also be annihilated.
因为他们不承认有至尊的这个超然灵性世界的存在，他们认为灵魂也是。灵魂这个物质也可以被毁灭。
So they have no information about the spiritual world. Even if they have information, they don't accept it. They only think about the material world.
他们对灵性世界没有概念，他们只知道物质世界。
So they go into this realm between the material and spiritual world.
所以他们会去到灵性世界和物质世界的这个中间地带。
And they stay there.So you can see the Srimad Bhagavatam gives us a complete description of the universe and all the different places beyond the universe, the spiritual world. We get the greatest information.
So we see that the Srimad Bhagavatam actually covers all of the including the description of the universe and the material world. We get the most information about these
knowledge. Other You know, if you go to Christianity, or if you ask them about the kingdom of God, they have no idea. They have no information.
如果你去到这些基督教等等其他的一些地方，你问他们，你能不能给我描述一下神的国度是怎样？他们没有这方面的概念。
And we see in the Bible, Jesus said, "There are many things I can tell you, but you're not ready to hear."
我们看到主耶稣在圣经里面也说了这样的话：我其实应该有很多东西要告诉给你们，但是你们并没有准备好。
And you've got the Buddhists, they're saying that you can go to the Buddha world and everybody's Buddha. They all want to become Buddha. That's their goal. They're thinking everybody should become the Buddha.
我们看到佛教里面的描述是，每个人都去到佛所在的地方，每一个人最终都要成为佛。
But we have much more information in Krishna consciousness.
但是我们在 Krishna 知觉之中却有更多的有关于这些方面的信息。
Okay, so we'll stop here and we'll ask if there's any questions.
好，我们今天讲到这儿，看现在来回答问题。First question from 真真 Hare Krishna, 亲爱的 Guru Maharaj, 顶拜您前面的莲花组，顶拜所有的奉献者。一，牛乃之羊的 Vishnu 和超灵有什么关系？ First question from 真真 Hare Krishna, obeisance to your sweet lotus feet.I want to ask, what is the relationship between the milk ocean Vishnu and the super soul? What's their relationship?
They're the same.
他们是一样的，牛奶之羊的 Vishnu 和超灵是一样的。
Yeah. The super soul appears in many different places at one time.
超灵在同一个时间显现在很多的地方。
But there's only one super soul.
但是只有一个超灵。
But he just appears in many places all at the same time.
他只是在同一个时间能够显现在所有的这些地方而已。
Just like Krishna was dancing Rasa Lila, so he was dancing with each of the gopis.
就像主 Krishna 在 Rasa 之舞的这个逍遥时光之中，他是和所有的牧牛姑娘都在跳舞，同时跳着舞。
So you should understand, there's one super soul, but he appears in everyone's heart.
你要理解的是只有一个超灵，但是它显现在每一个人的心中。
Not only is in everyone's heart, he's in every atom.
不仅仅是每一个人的心中，他在每一个原子之中。
And he's also in Shweta Dweep.
而且他还存在于 Shweta Dweep.
This is the inconceivable power of the super soul.
这就是超灵的不可思议的能量。
This is described at the end of the 10th chapter. If you read the Bhagavad Gita, you go to the 10th chapter and you go to the last verse of the 10th chapter.
这些都在《薄伽梵歌》的第十章的最后一个诗节之中有描述。
Now Lord Krishna had been describing about Vibhuti Yoga. He'd been describing.How he is present in so many different features in the material world.
主 Krishna 在解释为 Vibhuti Yoga 描述了他如何以这个在这个物质世界以如何以不同的形式显现在这个物质世界。
But then, after describing all of these things, he described about 80 of these different ways in which Krishna manifests himself in the material world.Then Krishna says, but Arjuna, there's no need for all this detailed knowledge, because with a single fragment of myself, I pervade and support the entire creation.
当主 Krishna 描述了他不同的展翅之后， 他最后又向阿尔朱娜描述道，了解到这些细节又有什么用呢？我只是用我辉煌的一闪创造并维系了整个物质世界。
So,
整个宇宙。
So, Jin Jin, we will ask you a question. Can you tell me what is that portion by which Krishna pervades and supports the entire creation?
Jin Jin Madhaji, 我们现在来问你，这个主 Krishna 的这个扩展，哪一个维系整个物质宇宙呢？真真妈的姐可以开麦哈，开麦克风。
他可以打字，
他也可以打字，对。
真真不知道，
真真妈的姐，您能回答一下吗？您可以打字，也可以直接说。他是怎样，至尊主是怎样维系了这个物质世界，遍布和维系了这个物质世界。
Okay, we'll
answer.
Yes.
我真真，我给你看，我给你权限了，你可以开麦说。哦，忘记了。他说忘记了。
She said she forgot.
Oh, okay. So it's a super soul.
就是至尊主以超灵的形式遍布和维系了整个宇宙。真真妈的姐。
And then in the seventh chapter, Krishna has also said, he said, there's no truth superior to me. He said, everything rests on me, just like pearls are strung on a thread.
就是主 Krishna 在薄伽梵歌中又说，一切就像如线穿珠一样。
So, Krishna, just like the thread, you have neck beads on, and there are beads around your neck. You can't see the thread, but there's a thread holding all the beads together.
如线穿珠是什么意思呢？就是一切这些珠子都是维系着的，但是我们却看不见这个珠子背后的那个绳子。
So the same.
就是这些珠子，它是在一个串上，但是我们看不见这个。背后的这个绳子维系着这个珠子。
So Krishna as the super soul is pervading everything and supporting everything.
主 Krishna 就是超灵，他维系着一切，支持着一切。
There is one super soul.
只有一个超灵。
But he appears in everyone's heart.
但是他显现在每一个人的心中。
Just like one sun is in the sky, but that one sun is reflected everywhere.
就像天空中只有一个太阳，但是它却照射到每一个地方。
Do you understand, Jin Jin?
Jin Jin, 你现在理解了吗？
Hare Krishna.可以听见我说话吗？
听到了，
可以听见。
就是我看到那个，就是还有一个问题，就是说，湿诺，然后奶之羊为湿诺，然后牛奶之羊为湿诺，进入到每个生物体的心中。这个指的是，然后这样，然后维士诺的展示就遍及了整个创造，然后这个，和牛
Fatima的姐, 我刚刚听到的有一点断续，您能不能大概给我？
对对，是断续的，我也没听清他问的是什么问题。真正
真正真正妈的姐，您给我一会儿打出来好吗？
可以可以可以啊。
好
好的
好的好的好的，谢谢您。Good day. She has another question, but she will
try
later.
I know. I know. I watch it.
Okay. We next question.
Yeah.
Okay. Next question from Yuna. Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisances. O Guru Tikshila Papa. Can we offer Krishna food prepared according to national traditions such as pizza or pasta in either? Will Krishna accept it? Does he like it?
Yes, if you...
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj, 请接受卑微的顶拜，一切荣耀归生爸爸的。我们是否可以为 Krishna 准备当地传统的食物，比如说披萨、这个意面等等？ Krishna 会接受吗？他会喜欢？
Yes, Krishna will accept, and Krishna likes. If you offer it, if you prepare it with love and devotion, according to the principles of cleanliness.
是的。Krishna 会喜欢也会接受，如果你是怀着奉爱的心态去准备的，以及遵随的这些原则，清洁的这些原则为 Krishna 去准备的， Krishna 会喜欢也会接受的。
Krishna wants love and devotion, that's the main qualification.
Krishna 希望要的是奉献爱和奉爱，这是最主要的资格。Next question.
Yeah.
Next question from Rajendra Prabhu. 顶拜亲爱的 Maharaj， 顶拜甜美的翻译。启迪这个词到底是什么意思？只是给灵性名字、念珠、发誓、火祭等等这些外在的仪式吗？启迪这个词有没有更深的含义？谢谢。Obeisance to dear Maharaj, what's the meaning, what's the real meaning of the initiation? Does it just mean the spiritual name and the japa beads and the swell and the yagya or other outside the ceremony?
So
I want to know the deep meaning of the initiation.
Initiation means the beginning, of your real spiritual practice.
启迪是启迪的意思是你灵性修习的开始。
Because at the time of initiation, you make your vow that you're going to follow four principles and chant 16 rounds.
因为在你启迪的时候，你要发誓开始遵守誓言。遵守四项基本原则，开始念诵。
And at that time, the spiritual master agrees to accept you.
在那一刻，你的灵性导师也答应要接受你。
And the spiritual master agrees to help you on the way back to Godhead.
你的灵性导师答应要帮助你回归守神。
So that's the real meaning of the initiation.
这就是启迪的真正的含义。
We become connected to the disciplic succession.
我们开始和师徒传承有连接。Next question from 真真。Krishna 以超念的形式存在于每个生物体的心中，指导着生物的活动。物质世界是主 Krishna， 物质世界是 Krishna。能量的非人格展示，超灵是人格的展示，是这样理解吗？当我们看到身边的人，就可以理解为他是个体灵魂，是 Krishna 的一部分，但 Krishna 是以超灵的形式居住在他们的心中，所以我要尊敬他，尽量尽我最大可能的不要冒犯他，即使他做了令我很生气的事情，也要忍耐，这样理解是正确的吗？ OK。And Krishna, as a superstar in every living thing's heart, the material world is the Krishna's impersonal energy manifest, and the super soul is the person manifest. Is that right understanding?
I've never heard it explained like that before.
我以前没有这样听过这样的理解。
She's saying the material world is an impersonal feature?
Yeah, she said the material world is Krishna's impersonal energy manifest. That's the... Yeah.
Material world is the manifestation of the impersonal energy. Well, yeah, we could say, because everything comes from Brahman, the material world is coming from the Brahman, and the Brahman is the impersonal feature.
你可以这样理解一部分，就是说，因为物质世界是来自于主 Brahman, 就是来自于 Brahman, 就是来自于这个梵。而这个梵 Brahman 又来自于至尊主的非人格的能量。
But we could also say that it's Krishna, it's Krishna's energy, so it's not impersonal.
但我们也可以说这是主 Krishna 的能量，它也不是，那不是非人格的。
Because it's all from Krishna, it's all part of Krishna's potency.
都是主 Krishna 的一部分，都是主 Krishna 的能量。And the super soul is Krishna's personal energy.
Super soul is the expansion of Krishna.
超灵是至尊主 Krishna 的扩展。Then she asked her, when we see people around, can we see he is the part of the Krishna? But Krishna also has a super soul in his heart. So we should respect him, not offend him. Even if he do some things that make me very angry, we should tolerate. Is that right?
Yes, if you can come to that platform, that's very good.
是的，你如果能够这样理解，这是很好的。
You have to be a little advanced to see Krishna in the heart of everyone.
你需要有一点点进步的这个眼光去看 Krishna 在每一个人的心中。
We encourage you try to see the distinction.First of all, we offer our respect to Lord Krishna and we worship Lord Krishna as the Supreme Lord.
我们也需要有一些区分。首先，主 Krishna, 我们崇拜主 Krishna, 我们崇主 Krishna 是以作为至尊人格守神的形式，我们崇拜着他。
Then there are the devotees of Krishna, so we make friends with the devotees of Krishna. We have loving exchanges with the devotees of Krishna.
然后关于主 Krishna 的奉献者，因为他是主 Krishna 的心爱的奉献者，所以我们要和主 Krishna 的这些奉献者结交成朋友，跟他们有一些友谊爱心的交流。
And then there's the innocent people who want to understand, they're willing to hear about Krishna, so we give mercy to them.
然后还有一些另外的一些人，他们什么都不知道，他们但是想要去了解 Krishna。我们于是就给予他们一些仁慈，让他们去理解 Krishna。
And then there's the atheists and the blasphemers, so we avoid these people.
还有一些人，他是属于冒犯者、亵渎者，他属于无神论者，我们就得避免这些人。
So we want to see these different classes of people. You should know who to associate with and who to avoid.
这样我们就很清楚，我们到底应该谁联谊，和谁避免谁的联谊。
Okay.
Okay. Next question from Vidava Madhati. 顶拜孤乳感恩翻译，请问恶魔为什么老是去打扰办事人呢？ Obeisance to Guru, and I want to ask why the demon always disturb the demigod. Thank you.
That is the nature.
这就是恶魔的本性。
We said that demon was created with the purpose of killing Indra.
我们说到这个恶魔被创造，他就是要去杀 Indra。
The demons always want to conquer the heavenly planets, and to conquer the heavenly planets, they have to be able to defeat the demigods.
这些恶魔总是想征服天堂星球，他要征服天堂星球，就得把这些半神人给打败。
The demons, they live in the subterranean heavenly planets, which is at the bottom of the universe.
这些恶魔他们住在整个宇宙的底部。
And it's very dark there.
那里非常的黑暗。
There's no light there.
没有光。
Everything is lit by jewels.
所有的这个光都是由珠宝发射出的光所照亮的。
So the demons like to conquer the heavenly planets and take control.
所以我就想把天堂给征服了，去控制天堂。
And they can live in the higher planets and they can control the universe.
他就可以住在高等的星球，控制整个宇宙了。
But they're not devotees. Krishna doesn't want them to control the universe.
因为他们不是奉献者，所以主 Krishna 不希望他们去控制整个宇宙。
Okay, next question.
Okay, next question from Govinda Nandini Mataji. 不同的人 from Hari Vamsa. 不同的人有不同的理解，就有不同的居所。这是不是灵性世界的多样性？但在物质世界，就算一个人不相信轮回，也被迫轮回。这种物质概念的理解，是不是也存在多样性？要是受大自然的法律，而是要受大自然的法律的控制。First, he asked, different people have different understanding, and then have the different destination.So this also means the spiritual world, the diversity of the spiritual world.
Yes.
是的。这个是灵性世界，这个是代表了灵性世界的多样性。
We have to, Krishna arranges to accommodate the desires of every living entity.
Krishna 安排这一切也是为了满足不同的生物体的愿望。
Different people have their different desires. What they want.
不同的人他有不同的愿望。
So Krishna arranges for everyone.
所以 Krishna 为每一个人安排好了这一切。
Yeah.
在物质世界，就算一个人不相信轮回，也被迫轮回，这种物质概念的理解是。不是不存在多样性。But in the material world, if one didn't believe the reincarnation, but he is forced to be in reincarnation. So the material conception, it means in the material conception.There is no diversity in this material conception, because everyone must be controlled by the material nature. Can you understand, Gurudev?
Not really, no.
I also become a little confused. I think his question is, the main point is, in the material world,because everyone are forced to be reincarnation, as he think there is no reincarnation in the material world because everyone are controlled by the material law.
Yes, everyone's controlled by material law. So it's a material law that, that you take birth again. That's the law. It's a material law that you have to take birth again, take another body, get the results of your work. You're creating, by your karma, you're creating karma, and you're going to get the results of that karma in another body.
是的，在物质世界你就得遵守这个法律，或者说接受这个法律。你创造了什么样的业报，你就得创造了什么样的活动，就接受怎么样的业报，或者说得到什么样的躯体。
There are laws of material nature. So it's a law that you take birth again, take birth again, keep on taking birth.
物质世界的法律就是说，你需要投生，然后再次投生。Next question.
Okay.
Next question from Radhe Sham. 顶拜 Guru Day, 顶拜翻译。不再用了的旧念珠是否可以挂在脖子上当颈珠？Guru Dev, if the old japa beads, can we use it around the neck? Use it as a neck bead?
If you want, you can, yeah?
如果你想这么做的话，你可以这么做。
Yeah, no problem.
Okay. 没有问题，就是说如果你想把这个旧念珠挂在自己的脖子上，你是可以这么挂的。And the next question also from the Honey Vamsa. 有时候轮回与重新投生的运作过程让人觉悟到神的法律是这么神奇和不可思议，但心意无法理解，又让人产生怀疑，怎样去除这种怀疑？ Sometimes this kind of reincarnation andtake birth again, this kind of process make me understand that the laws, the law of the Lord are very inconceivable. But in my mind, sometimes I have some doubts and I count on this kind of process. So how to remove this kind of doubt?
Well, you remove doubts by developing your faith in the Krishna conscious philosophy.
你要去你的怀疑是通过你发展 Krishna 知觉的信心。
You have to increase your own faith in the knowledge of Krishna by hearing and chanting.
你增加你 Krishna 知觉的信心通过聆听和唱诵。
So, Krishna, Arjuna had doubts. Arjuna had doubts, and he addresses Lord Krishna as Madhusudana. Madhusudana killed the demon Madhu. So he said his doubts are like demons, and Krishna can kill the demon of doubts.
Arjuna 也有怀疑。于是他就称呼 Krishna 为 Madhusudana， Madhusudana 就是杀掉恶魔的那个人。他把这个恶魔比喻为是这种怀疑。
So you have to take more shelter of Lord Krishna by hearing Lord Krishna's teachings and then get rid of all the doubts.
所以你要更加托庇于主 Krishna， 然后摆通过托庇于 Krishna 来摆脱这去除这种。
Yeah, people always have doubts. Everyone will have some doubts. But these doubts can be removed by the process of Krishna consciousness.
每一个人都会有一些怀疑， 但是这些怀疑可以通过 Krishna 知觉的程序被逐渐的清除掉。
So you have to just become more absorbed in hearing from Lord Krishna.
所以你要更沉浸于听有关于 Krishna 的话，这些有关于 Krishna 的话题。
And then certainly all these doubts can just be disappeared. They all disappear.
好。能确保你的就是在一定的时候这些怀疑都会被清除掉。
Just like the birds come in the field, the birds come and you clap your hands, and when you clap your hands, then all the birds fly away.
就像在田地里面有很多鸟都飞来了，但是如果你一拍巴掌，一拍，所有的鸟都飞走了。
So these doubts are just like these birds.
这些鸟就像这些怀疑就像这些鸟一样。
So just take shelter of the holy name, clap your hands, and chant and dance, and all these doubts will be removed.
所以托庇于圣名，托庇于圣名，聆听唱诵和跳舞，所有的这些怀疑都会被清除。都会被去除。Next question from 真真。Mahavishnu 是 Krishna 的全权部分的全权部分，主 Krishna 是原初者，然后这位 Mahavishnu 再次以运旦之阳的 Vishnu 进入到每一个宇宙之中，从运旦之阳 Vishnu 就有了牛奶之阳 Vishnu， 然后牛奶之阳 Vishnu 进入到每一个身体之中。就这样 ，Vishnu 遍及了整个创造 ，Mahavishnu 和运旦之阳 ，Vishnu 和牛奶之阳 ，Vishnu 是什么关系？和超灵和我们是什么关系？Her question is, what is the relationship between the Mahavishnu and the Garbhodakshayi Vishnu and the Kshirodakshayi Vishnu? What's their relationship?
Well, they're
and what's the relationship with the super soul and between the us? Sorry.
Super soul and what?
就是这些 Vishnu 和超灵和我们 and us.
Okay.
和我们的关系，对 Hare Krishna.
So the super soul is the expansion of Lord Krishna.
超灵是主 Krishna 的一个扩展。
And the living entities, we're described in the seventh chapter of the Bhagavad Gita, we're the superior prakriti.
在《薄伽梵歌》的第七章中，我们被描述到，就是被描述我们，就是描述到我们是高等的能量。
And now, Mahavishnu.Is the first Vishnu. Mahavishnu is the first Vishnu. He's laying on the causal ocean, and the universes are coming out from his body. He's Karanadakshayi Vishnu.
Mahavishnu 指的就是 Karanadakshayi Vishnu. 他躺在这个宇宙之中，这个宇宙就是从他而来。
Then Vishnu expands himself into each universe.
然后这个 Mahavishnu 就扩展他自己进入到每一个宇宙之中。
He enters into each universe as Garbhodakshayi Vishnu.
他进入到每一个宇宙之中就是 Garbhodakshayi Vishnu.
And he lays down in the bottom of the ocean, first of all,Water comes out from his body, and he makes the ocean in the bottom of the universe. Then he lays down on that ocean of water, and a lotus flower comes out from his navel, and Lord Brahma takes birth from the lotus.
他进入到每个宇宙之中，然后他就在宇宙的底部躺下，水从他的身体流眼出来，他 他躺下之后，然后从他的肚脐上产出一个莲花镜，主 Brahma 从这个莲花镜上莲花诞生出来。
So there are many, many universes, and in each universe there's a Garbhodak Kshaya Vishnu.
有很多很多的宇宙，每一个宇宙都是 Garbhodak Kshaya Vishnu.
And then there's a Shirodak Kshaya Vishnu, who is this, in Sweta Dweep. There's an island called Sweta Dweep.On the Milk Ocean. In the Milk Ocean, there's one island of Sweta Dweep, and Lord Vishnu is residing there. He's called Shirodakshayi Vishnu.
在宇宙的毁灭的时候，就是 Shirodakshayi Vishnu 有他们，就是主 Vishnu Shirodakshayi Vishnu 在他的 Sweta Dweep 那个地方。
And he's also the super soul in the heart of everyone.
Shirodakshayi Vishnu 也是每一个人心中的超灵。
So you should understand, there's one Vishnu, but he has different. We have these three different names. They're all Vishnu, but they're doing different functions.
你要理解的是，只有一个 Vishnu, 他们都称作 Vishnu, 但是他们是做着不同的功，有着不同的功能。
So I've explained them to you again. I'd explained in the class. I'm explained it again to you.
我们在讲课之中讲过这个部分，然后我现在又单独给你解释了一遍。
So I hope you've got it clear now. If you haven't, then I hope you recorded it and you can just listen to the recording again.
我希望你能够记录下来。如果你不能够理再不能理解的话，我需要希望你能够再一次聆听一下。
Okay.
Next question from Shama. Hare Krishna, 顶拜 Guru Maharaj 和所有奉献者，在瓦坛之中，因者作为天堂的君主，总是充满嫉妒，制造各种麻烦，最后被主亲自解决了。这些。因是同一位吗 ？Krishna 为什么不惩罚他吗？不惩罚他呢 ？Hare Krishna, obeisances to Guru Maharaj and devotees. In the Srimad Bhagavatam, Indra as the king of the heaven, but he is always full of the envy and give a lot of trouble. At last, he killed by the Lord himself. So this so many these Indra are the same Indra. Why the Lord Krishna himself punishes the Indra?
Where did you hear that Krishna killed Indra? I never heard this.
你在哪里听到这个 Indra 被主亲自解决了？就是说，我不知道您这个解决是指的杀了还是什么？您在哪里？听到这个 Indra 被解决了。
We heard Indra became proud, and Indra sent the clouds, and he was going to destroy Vrindavan, and Krishna picked up Govardhan Hill, and made Indra humble.
我们听到的是 Indra 他做了，他制造了很多的云，他想把这个 Vrindavan 给毁灭，然后最后主 Krishna 亲自惩罚他，让他变得。就是主 Krishna 亲自举起哥瓦丹山，让主让天地 Indra 变得谦卑起来。
Hare Krishna， 夏玛他说不是解决了 Indra， 他是说解决了麻烦，亲自解决了麻烦。
嗯，哦 ，OK，
So yeah, he became proud. So Krishna corrected him by picking up the Govardhan Hill, and then Indra became humble.
Indra 变得骄傲了。主 Krishna 亲自举起了哥尔巴丹山，然后 Indra 变得谦卑起来。
So that was Krishna's punishment. He took away the pride.
这就是。
He took away the pride of Indra.
这就是主 Krishna 的惩罚，他拿走了 Indra 的骄傲。
But Indra is a devotee. He's also a devotee. He's a demigod. He's the king of heaven. And he does a lot of service for Krishna.
与此同时 ，Indra 也是一个奉献者。他为主 Krishna 做了很多的服务。他是天堂的国王。
And he has to fight the demons, just like we're hearing in the Srimad Bhagavatam. He has to fight these big demons when they come along.
而且他还得跟这些恶魔打仗。当这些恶魔来的时候，他得跟恶魔战斗。
So Lord Krishna appreciates the service of Indra.
所以主 Krishna 也欣赏 Indra 的服务。
But he knows that sometimes people become proud. They get a big position, they become proud.
主 Krishna 也知道有一些人得到巨大的位置之后，他会变得骄傲起来。
Sometimes we get a lot of money, we become proud.
有些时候我们钱多了之后就开始骄傲了。
Sometimes we get a nice husband or a nice wife, we become proud.
有些时候我们娶了一个好妻子或者嫁给了一个好丈夫之后，我们也会觉得骄傲起来。
So Krishna makes us humble.
所以主 Krishna 就让他变得谦卑起来。
Krishna doesn't like to see his devotees become proud.
Krishna 不想看见他的奉献者骄傲。
So he arranged for Indra to become humble.
所以他安排了这一切，让 Indra 变得谦卑。
Yeah.
Yeah. Next question from Vaishnava Vani Mataji.Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj, my humble basis, you are mentioned a word about Pitraloka. I want you to understand who will go to the Pitraloka. Is it like all death family members with good credit go to the Pitraloka? Is it a compulsory for the devotees like me to do the Shraddha?Or other rituals related to the death of the family member. What can we do as a devotee when a family member like my mother or father dies? Hare Krishna, 请接受我卑微的顶拜，古鲁马哈人。您提到一个 Pitraloka， 我想知道谁会去 Pitraloka， 是不是就是说家里死去的这些亲。这一些家庭成员他们都会去到 Pitraloka， 像我们这样的奉献者必须在就是奉献者的家人如果死了之后是不是也要做这样的 Shraddha 或者说其他的仪式呢？当我的父亲和母亲或这样的比较重要的家庭成员去世时，作为奉献者我们应该做一些什么？ Hare Krishna。
Yes, well, Pitraloka is like a higher planet, and people who worship their forefathers, if they've got a lot of pious activities, they can go up there to, they can go to the Pitraloka.
Pitraloka 是一个相对高等的星球，就是当一个人他崇拜了他的祖先，然后他也做很多的虔诚活动的时候，他可以去到这个。
And the purpose of the Shraddha ceremony is to take away the sinful reactions so that the person can go up to the Pitraloka.
而我们所说的 Shraddha 这样的一些祭祀仪式的这个目的是为了能够去除这些人的罪恶活动的反应，能够让他去到 Pitraloka。
So it's in the material world, it's not outside the material world.
但仍然这都是在物质世界，不是远离物质世界的地方。
And you have to have pious activities to stay there.
你如果有虔诚活动的话，你就可以留在那里。
So usually people do the Shraddha ceremony for the departed souls to help the ancestors to elevate them to higher positions in the material world.
通常情况下一些人们为他的离去的家人做这个 Shraddha 仪式，是希望他们能够去除一些罪恶活动，能够让他们得到提升， 提升去到一些高等的星球。
So the short ceremony is done. It's not really necessary for devotees. If your whole family are devotees, then it's not really required. But there is a Shraddha ceremony which is done according to the Vaishnava mantras. Without, you know, there are Shraddha ceremonies which are just ritualistic, which are, you know, Vedic, and they worship demigods and so on. But there's also Shraddha ceremony which is done according to Vaishnava tradition.
有一种 Shraddha， 它是根据伟达的传统和仪式，按照这个方法去做。但是如果你家人是和都是奉献者的话，可以不必那么做。我们有一个 Vaishnava 的 Shraddha 的这种仪式。
So in the case of departure of your family members, you can also invite a Vaishnava to do Shraddha ceremony on behalf of them.
如果你的家人，你的家人离开，你想为他做一个仪式的话，你也可以邀请 Vaishnava 的奉献者来为你的家人做这个仪式。
Now we see Lord Chaitanya at one point when his father died, he told his mother, he said, I'm going to Gaya. He said, I'm going to do Shraddha ceremony there for my father. So in this way, his mother allowed him to go to Gaya. There's a lotus footprint there of Lord Vishnu, and traditionally people would go there and worship that lotus footprint of Lord Vishnu as part of the Shraddha ceremony.
我们看到主 Chaitanya 的父亲，当他离开的时候，离开躯体的时候，主 Chaitanya 要想跟他的母亲说，我想为我的父亲去做个仪式，于是我想去 Gaya。因为在嘎雅的那个地方有主威士路的主莲花族的这个族印，通常他们崇拜这个主威士路莲花族的这个族印作为 Shraddha 祭祀仪式的一个部分。
But actually Lord Chaitanya's purpose in going to Gaya was not to do the Shraddha, but his purpose was to get initiation, and he took Diksha from Ishwarapuri.
事实上主 Chaitanya 他去 Gaya 的真正目的不是想去做这个 Shraddha 仪式，而是想去得到 Diksha 的启迪，从 Ishwarapuri 那里得到 Diksha 的启迪。
Yeah. So, Lord, devotees, generally, we don't have to worry so much about doing this Shraddha ceremony. It's not very important.
奉献者不必要太过于担心这个刷打的仪式，这对奉献者来说不是很重要的一部分。
Right, we simply chant Hare Krishna, and that's much more beneficial than the Shraddha ceremony.
我们只是唱诵 Hare Krishna, 这个比刷打仪式会更有益处。
One devotee was in America with Prabhupada, and he got a letter from India saying that his father had died. And he said he wanted to go back to India to do the last rites for his father. But Prabhupada told him, he said, no, you don't have to do that. He said, you're a devotee now of Krishna. You're finished. You don't need to bother to do all these things. You just do your service for Krishna.
有一次有一个奉献者，他的父亲离开躯体了，他说他想回印度为他的父亲做这个仪式。然后他就写信给帕帕，告诉了圣帕帕的，告诉了这一切。圣帕帕的说：“你不必要回印度再去做这个仪式，因为你现在已经是奉献者了，你继续做好你的服务就行了。”
Just like Prahlad Maharaj wanted that his father would not go to hell, so the Lord Narsingadev told him that because you're a devotee, not only your father.But for many generations, all your ancestors are all liberated.
Prahlad Maharaj 在非常就是在最后，他非常他向主祈祷，他说能否让我的父亲不要去到地狱？于是主力圣和 Deva 跟他说，因为你是奉献者，所以不仅仅是你，你的很多代这些亲戚，你的这些家人， 都会得到解脱。
Okay.
Okay. I think the final question from the Sugita Sangha Mataji, Hare Krishna, 感恩侮辱和翻译。Indra 有当过猪的经历，那他为什么被贬当猪呢？Hare Krishna, basis to thanks Guru and the translators. The Indra have the experience of to be a pig. So why he should be a pig?
Yeah, it's Guru custom to become a pig because he was offensive. He made great offenses to his Guru. He was absorbed in sense gratification.
他之所以被贬成为一个猪，是因为他冒犯了这个灵性导师，冒犯了灵性导师，他太依附于他的感官享乐了。
You know, sometimes Indra becomes bewildered by all the beautiful women who surround him.
有些时候 ，Indra 就被身边的这些美女围绕的这些美女所迷惑。
And so his guru thought it would be good for him to become a pig, help him to.
所以。
Come to his senses.
所以他的孤儒就觉得，哎呀，这个Indra就应该去当个猪。
So he cursed him to become a pig.
所以他的灵性导师诅咒他成为了一头猪。
Because he was living in so much opulence as the king of heaven, surrounded in opulence and served by so many people and beautiful women.So then he became a pig, and he was living in the pig barn, and he was eating pig food.
因为他在天堂上作为国王，他享受着太多的物质的富裕，被太多的美女所环绕，所以他被灵性导师诅咒为成为一头猪，吃着猪食，然后住在猪圈里。
And so he became.So happy there. He was actually comfortable. He was enjoying it. He didn't want to leave. When his guru came and told him to come back, he said, Oh, I'm happy here. I like it here. I get a lot of food and I have all my wives and I have all my children here. I'm very happy here.
当他的孤儒再来看他的时候，他发现 Indra, 他说你该回来了。但是 Indra, 当时作为那个猪的这个 Indra, 他就说哦、oh, ，我现在过得非常的快乐，我现在吃的也非常好，我的这些我也有很多的妻子，我的这都有家庭了，我都过得非常好，我不想回去。
So then his guru had to go and get the butcher, and when the butcher came with a big knife, and then they were going to get Indra, they said, "Where's the big fat pig?" And then Indra understood that he better stop being the pig.
所以。他的老师就安排了那个屠夫来，那个屠夫来了之后说，那个最肥的那个猪在哪里？那个时候 Indra 就开始反应过来了，最好我应该离开这个猪的这个躯体回去。
Okay, so.
Okay, okay.
We'll stop.
And Hare Krishna Guru, Hare Vamsa, give one more question. Should we?
Yeah, it's a quick question.
Okay. Vaishnava, 普通奉献者离开躯体火化骨灰到恒河了，是不是都需要墓地来让亲人悼念？这个对灵性进步有帮助吗？ If the Vaishnava, leaving the body and then, doing the ceremony, the ashes go to the Ganges. So should we give a samadhi to this Vaishnava and, let the relatives can come.
What do you mean, give samadhi? We don't give samadhi to anybody except sannyasis.
我们不给除了 sannyasi, 我们不给他们墓地。
Everybody, all the bodies get burned. Even often sannyasis' bodies also get burned.
即便是萨尼亚西，它也是火化的。
And then they have the ashes, and they use the ashes to put the samadhi for the sannyas.
然后他们有一些骨灰，然后让这个骨灰作为这个萨尼亚西的 samadhi。
In some countries, you have to do that.
有一些国家他们是这样做的。Sorry, good day. He said the cemetery.
Cemetery.
Yeah.
Well, devotees don't usually get buried. Cemetery is to bury. Bury the body.
Mm.
And then what did he say?
Should we, after burn the body, should we also have a cemetery for this devotee?
Well, usually the ashes go, put the ashes in the Ganga.
通常情况下是把这个骨灰放到恒河里面。And whether this cemetery have the spiritual advancement for these people, can help the spiritual advancement for this?
For the dead body? For the person who left the body?
For the relatives or Vaishnavas?
Well, I don't know, it's questionable. Some sannyasis, like they have disciples, so the disciples, they want to have the samadhi, they like to go to the samadhi to offer respect to their guru.
有一些sannyasi他的门徒是希望他的孤儒有一个 samadhi， 然后他能够经常去那个 samadhi 悼念他的孤儒。
And they celebrate, they offer the food just like we have samadhis here in Mayapur, so they make offerings every day to the samadhis.
然后就像我们在马耶普也有这个 samadhi， 有很多人他每天是要给这个 samadhi 供奉的。
Yeah, the food which is offered to Prabhupada, after it's offered to Prabhupada, then portion of it is offered at the samadhis.
这个食物首先是供奉给圣帕帕的，然后再把圣供奉给圣帕帕的这个食物，然后再供奉给这个 samadhi 的这些灵性导师。
So the samadhis, they help people to learn about different devotees, about what they did, what service they did for Krishna.And how they give up their life in Krishna's service.
我们让这个 samadhi 是有这个 samadhi 是了解到这个奉献者到底这个灵性导师这个奉献者到底他做的哪些服务，然后他以及他是如何离开躯体。
Of course, we have a lot of sannyasis now in ISKCON, and they don't want to have samadhis everywhere.
当然我们现在也有很多的 sannyasi 在 ISKCON， 他们不想要到处有这个 samadhi。
So it's unlikely there'll be a lot of samadhis everywhere. It's not going to happen.
到处都是 samadhi 这种情况也不会发生。
But we have Prabhupada Samadhi, that's the main one. You can go to Prabhupada Samadhi, and yes, it's purifying to go there.
我们有圣帕帕德的 Samadhi， 然后去到圣帕帕德 Samadhi， 毫无疑问，这个是很净化的。
We have Tamal Krishna Goswami's Samadhi. It's also good to go there and offer obeisances.
然后我们有 Tamal Krishna Goswami 的 Samadhi， 去那里顶拜也是非常好。
Okay.Vama Ganshya Saburi Raige, Vama Jantai Dufani, Ganshya Soida Functions at Ling Ting, T1, Vama Jufu Niman, Wanshya Rui, Chuan Jiao Shun Li, Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada Ki,
Jai,
Gaur Bhakta Vrinda Ki.